through your drunkenness. I'll be minding my own business, doing my own thing in a little place called Hanau, Germany. And the Lord came in that place and saved my soul. And they had a little missionary up in there. They called it aspiring missionaries back then. And the church was brought in Christ. Amen. And the Lord, it's like he threw me to the wolves. Yeah, we had an old mother in there, Mother Long. Mother Yellow, she used to say, baby, she ain't take no mess back then. You know, the mothers back then ain't take no mess. She said, you need to get with the right crowd. Now she had that finger pointing at me. And she said, the missionary letting me know, you need to come on in here now, young man. You're getting it right. But how do you know it was back then those kind of foundational women of God that helped us to become what we are today? And we're so thankful. And then one of those inspiring missionaries was the overseer of the Outreach Temple. She is a great friend of mine. Would you help me appreciate overseer Ramona Whitson? Amen. She gave birth to a son by the name of Pastor Roger Walter. He wasn't pastor when he was born, but he was prophetic. So I'm going to ask them to come at this time and just share a word with us. Amen. Just come and greet us in the name of the Lord. Would you lift them a hand clap? Give them both a hand clap.
Celebrate with Bishop and Lady Benton. I love them so much. Amen. And so let me just tell you something right quick about Bishop. Yeah. Bishop was a good saint. I have to say that when he first got saved, you know, we were put in charge of him. He didn't know that. But Mother Long says to us, now y'all got to keep this young man straight. And you know, he played the drums. And so I was the choir director for the youth. And so we come in and practice and everything, and he'd be playing. I say, did you hear me say that? Now listen. He'd say, oh Lord, I done made a man. Amen. And so, but he was eager to learn. That's what I liked about I call him Kevin. You guys can't call him that. But I call him Kevin, and it's been over 30 years. And I remember when we were young, and the one thing that we did that the church didn't like was that we used to go out and witness. Kevin would get the people off his job and say, okay, we're going to be there at this time, and we're going to come, and we're going to witness, and we're going to, you know. So we were big on witnessing, and the church that we were going to say, y'all can't do that. Y'all can't. He don't know nothing. He not strong enough. I say, but he doing pretty good. So we would go out, I don't know if Kevin remember that, and witness to different concerns. And this is the thing that I like. We learned early to go out and witness for the Lord. If it was a man, Kevin would witness, and I would pray. And if it was a woman, then I would do the witnessing, and he would pray. But we always had each other's back. And so we continued on that journey because we both love God so much. And I remember telling Kevin when we was going, when I said, now I know this drunk man is not coming to me. Because, you know, I can't stand him. Kevin said, come on now. Come on, Mona. You got to say, no, buddy. You better go ahead and witness to him. He came up to us, and Kevin stepped out to witness. He told Kevin, and I want that lady right there. I told Kevin, it's time for us to go. Because I can't do this. I can't do this. But I thank God that he urged me on. He said, come on, Mona, he might accept Christ tonight. I said, well, if he accepts it tonight, he can accept it from you. But nevertheless, I went ahead and prayed, and Kevin backed me up. And so the guy did receive his faith that night, and he did receive salvation. I also want to talk about for a few minutes, I call her Lorraine. I don't know what y'all call her, but y'all probably can't call her that. It's been over 30 years, so. To me, they're like family, and it's, he's my little brother, and she's my sister, and amen, and so Lorraine was such a good wife, even then, because she didn't go, but Kevin did, but we have something in common, because we both went to the Skyline Club. Y'all ain't gonna say nothing. To eat, Kevin. What did I miss something? We went, the Skyline Club had what they call bingo. but they also had the best fried chicken in Hanau. And so on Friday nights after church, I would go to the Hanau Club and get me a plate of fried chicken. And of course, Lorraine would be there. And I said, you didn't cook today? Mm-mm. Okay, we got to really get on, you know, so they won't know we've been here. And so, you know, because back then, saints were not allowed to go into places where they were partying and doing all that. We weren't allowed to go there. But we know we wanted some chicken, so we know we had to get there and go in and come out. But I thank God that I've known her for that long, and she's been the same that long. Amen. So I just thank them for welcoming. I love her so. She has a good disposition. Her and I fit together. Have you ever met somebody where you fit together? Other people don't understand you, but we fit together. And so that's what I like about her. And she's steadfast, she's unmovable, and she's always abounding. Y'all ain't gonna say nothing, because it's good to have a first lady that's steadfast and unmovable and always abounding in the work of the Lord. It's good to have somebody like that, because some people that you have, you can't count on them. They're in your life, but you can't count on them. Y'all not gonna say nothing. So, amen.
Thank you for that, Dr. Silver. Brandon Reeves from Conyers, Georgia. Outreach Temple of Faith. Amen. We thank God for Dr. Bedman, his lovely wife, Lady Bedman. We thank you for the invitation to come out. Amen. The saints was. Dr. Bedman came down and tore the house up just in the seminar. And the saints fell in love with him. Amen. And his staff. Amen. We don't want to have these yours, but we can share them. Are you allowed that? We on the A-list. Okay. We on the A-list. Amen. Yeah, amen. So I got that A-list for my A-team, keeping them on the A-game. And he came down and he talked. Amen. And I ain't never heard it talk like that. And I think I just preached Judge yourself. And I was like, well, you know, anytime you can say something and have you open my Bible, okay. We got to go back to the drawing board. And I like that. That's how you get me. Amen. So, yes, we was in Germany from 79 to 85. Let me just wrap this up. 79 to 85. I was a little bitty thing when they was on the witness and fail. Amen. I was the one, amen, that they prayed heavy for. Yeah. I was that child. I don't know if Dr. Bedman remembers, but I remember when they had a testimony night for the young kids, and me and Wendy, which is Mother Long's son, and we wanted to go to the DYA that night. And you know, in Hanau, Germany, they were infamous for a Friday night service, and 30 minutes later, they called lock-ins. And you a child, you don't want to hear those words. And they did a lock-in one night, and I was determined to get them back. I was that child. And they asked for a testimony service, and I stood up. They said, tell us what the Lord done for you. And he said, what you want to be when you grow up? I said, a gigolo. In front of the church. And Mother Long, he got that finger. She talked real fast, too, from Waco, Texas. And then she said, Mom. Get Rogers. She never said Rogers, she said Rogers. And it was that night we got in trouble. And you know, I still want to be a gigolo, but I ran for a long time. See, I ran from my calling for a long time. I think when I finally got into it, they back then they called it a set aside deacon, which was new to me. Never really heard of that term, but it was set aside. And I got invited to preach at a church. And when I got there, there was all these apostles and these prophets, and I'm just a deacon set aside. And so they asked me, they said, we just want you to say a few words. And I said, well, I'm going to praise them. I just got over there. You know, I don't know what to say. He said, man, just say what you've been singing. I looked around all these apostles, and looked at my mom, and I looked at my family, and I said, they ain't going to miss me. They ain't going to miss me. So they had went back home to go to work, come back down and hear me preach Friday night or say something. Child, by the time they got down to 20, we was on our way back home. And so they've been calling me the runaway deacon since. Ran from everything. But
Amen. I thank God. I thank God for the invitation. Continue to praise and thank God for you. Amen. Wonderful God. Amen. And I told him, I said, we're going to stay Sunday. So you know we must love y'all. We shut our church down. And the members, some of the members that went back and some that didn't come, they were like, Pastor, are we going to have, do you want to have service? And I was looking, I was just playing with them. I said, I ain't assigned a team yet, y'all. No. We ain't assigned no team yet, y'all. Leave the church alone. Wait till I get back and we'll do all of that. Amen. But for those that came out with us, thank God for you. Amen. Bishop, they made their own way. So we really thank God for you, man of God, and we look forward to many more fellowships. God bless you.
Praise the Lord. Tell them to go get from you. Amen. I have really enjoyed my time, particularly with my outreach family. And we're getting ready to hear the word of the Lord. Amen. And I understand we have a special presentation after the, give me the program, because I'll be a mess up. Amen. I had the program. Thank you, sir. Thank you. I know it is, yes, our special presentation. Welcome to our family. And I'm going to go ahead and introduce our speaker. And after that, I believe the Fine Arts Ministry, they're going to minister.
Yes, sir.
Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
All right, they're going to minister, and then we're going to be in the hands of our preacher. When we were considering who we wanted to close out our anniversary on this year, this man of God came to my mind. And because we have had such a good closing, you know, it's hard to have friends for 2 days. But when you can keep them for 20 plus years, then you know you really have something to say. And Pastor Elder Lowell Thomas is one of those brothers who I've known for a long, long time. We shared military careers together. We just kind of followed one another. He was an engineer, I was an engineer. He was a drill sergeant, I was a drill sergeant. Amen. And we were kind of watching one another from a distance. And our military careers were kind of going right alongside one another until he decided I'm staying in for 30 years. And I said, I'm getting out at 20. And he stayed in for 30 years, made sergeant major. I said, I'll take first sergeant, man, and I'll see you later. But the Lord blessed him, and he came to the cathedral. Back then it was the temple, him and his dear wife, Phyllis, and they joined the ministry with us, and they helped us to become what we are today. Yes. There are many that we're speaking of him today. He helped us, amen, holding many different departments while he was here. Amen. Never murmured, never complained, never tried to take over, never tried to be the pastor in the corner, parking lot pastor, all of that foolishness. Amen. Would put people in their places until he knew it was his season. And so the Lord said, now it's your season, son. He retired, went up to Virginia. Amen. Him and his dear wife, the Lord blessed them up there. Then the Lord opened up a door for him to become the pastor of his father's church. And so when he comes back to us this time, he doesn't come to us as Elder Lowell Thomas, but he comes to us as Pastor Lowell Thomas. Amen. So he is the pastor of the new True Way Church of our Lord Jesus Christ out of Washington, D.C. Him and his dear wife, Phyllis, have come all the way down here to be with us, and we want to treat them with kindness. Amen. We nicknamed him the helicopter. I'm going to tell you why. You ready? Because if you ride a 747, you know, it takes a 747 a long time. They got to run down here, and then they rise up. I don't like preachers like that. I like preachers just poof. They up, they circling, and they gone. And Elder Thomas is going to play. You know, not that those that did that did play, but he's the kind of preacher that lets us know right out the gate what God has to say for us. And amen. We appreciate him on today. So after our special presentation, after the Fine Arts Ministry, if you would stand around the building and receive our guest preacher, he's our brother in the Lord on today. Would you clap your hands now and say, Lord, bless Pastor Thomas. Clap your hands and give God praise and special praise.
And our theme is, it's a family affair. So we are celebrating all of our new families who have joined us within the last 3 months. Media has a presentation, and then afterwards, I'm going to call each family And if you will please stand where you are at your table so that we can recognize you.
Come on, give God some praise. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on, we need the Lord. Come on, ask. I don't know if nobody else was following the role play, but it was reality. Come on, it's reality. Sometimes what we do around others, amen, is contagious. Come on, talk back to me. It's contagious. Amen. We saw them, amen, doing their own little thing. But in the process, they heard, I need the Lord. Because you're sitting here today because you need the Lord. Come on, it's a family up there. Nobody's here because you was good. Nobody here because you deserved it. But somebody know that you were wrong. And it took time. And you realize it. I need the Lord. Come on, I need you. I need you. I need you. Come on, we need you today, Lord. I need you right now, Lord. I don't know about it, but I need you right now. I tell my church all the time, there's no guarantee that you see 1:30. But the thing is, Lord, you got to realize, Lord, I need you right now. Because, Lord, if you call me for 1:30, I realize I have received you, and then I can go back to be with you. I don't know what about it, but it's ministered to my heart. Even to the role players, amen, that was sincere in the roles that they was playing. Kind of like the overseer was saying, sometimes, you know, they may be drunk, but they really just need a word. Sometimes we walk past them because we say, they're not even working. But the truth be told, they need the Lord. Come on, we need the Lord. We need the Lord. The old traditional song said, I need the old, I need
neighbor, I need the Lord.
If it had not been for the Lord on my side, where would I be? Oh, come on, only you can answer it. Cause I'm with God close. If it had not been for the Lord on my side. It was 2:10. I said, well, if I go now, I'm going to get the same things. I might as well stay till I get to 4. If I get to 4, I can drink a little bit more. But thank me to God. But now I can't wait to get in the house of the Lord. I used to ice to turn the lights out. But now I'm turning the lights on. So when I think where the Lord had brought me from, I got a right to give him glory. I got a right to give him praise. Look what the Lord has done. Leave that thing alone, Phil. I'm trying to preach. But you put it right there. Have your seats in the presence of the Lord. I told you on Friday evening, if you give me 20 preaching minutes and 2 30-second commercial, I'll let you out the house. But about nobody else, but I already done had church. If you don't get your dance, I don't. Hallelujah. And Temple, as you can see, I still slide on my 1 foot, Sister Johnson. She would always remember, she said, look at Elder, he's up on the 1 foot, amen. But I still think. Hallelujah. Glory to God. First, give an honor to God, who is truly the head of my life. Thank God for Bishop Benton, amen, my friend and my brother. Come on, give him a hand. To his wife, my first lady, amen, Sister Lorraine Benton. And I would just tell you this, Bishop was not just saying it because we both a ditto. We feel the same way about each other. And I was told him when I got in the city on Friday, I was reminiscing from the drive here, how we had so much in common. And I was watching him, and he's right, I was watching him, not only the military career, but the life that he lived. And he, I know he shared with the show, and I was hearing. I remember when he got selected as, some of you may know, he was selected as Drill Sergeant of the Year in TRADOC. And back then it was big competition. And everybody kept saying, hey, this guy from over Delta 1-2 done got it, that Benton guy. Man, that guy squared away, he shot. And I said, well, let me check this cat out. I thought I was the baddest thing on the hill. I mean, when it came down to modulating and drilling, I thought I was the man. He said, that Benton guy with the Delta 1-2, and I saw him, and he made that recall, and I said, man, congratulations. And that was the local level at Fort Leonardwood. Went all the way up to TRADOC, and he won Drill Sergeant of the Year. So that inspired me. He said, you know, then the Lord allowed our pastors over, and we both ended up in the readiness group together. So our first classes together and all that. So what I'm saying all that to say this, we have been friends down through the years. and God have allowed both of us, amen, to do something that neither one of us probably knew that we could do. If you ever read it, you got. I'm promoting this book. If you haven't read the book, read the book. It tells a little bit where he came from to where he's going. So I thank you, Bishop, for having me here, being back home. This morning he was in Auburn, and I told him, I said, look, Bishop, I'm not here. I said, now, if I was one of these big bishops and apostles and potentates, I said, you could probably do it. I said, but I'm just your son coming back home, handling business. All I need to do is just get what I'm doing now. You just tell you a word. I thank God for you. Amen. Overseer, thank God for you. Thank God for you, my God. Pastor Boston, he and I had an opportunity to sit last evening, and we were sharing like we've been knowing each other down through the years. Amen. And had a lot of things in common. Thank you for your wife, your Boston. Amen. We thank God for everybody in the household of faith, because everybody is somebody's in God's house. And I'll be remiss. Yes, tomorrow we'll celebrate 35 years, but I've been knowing this woman for 43 years. Again, Pastor and I have a lot in common because Phyllis and I, we was high school sweetheart. I think just like Lorraine and Kevin, I can call them that, but I know I'm Bishop for like, but we're on that level, Lorraine and Kevin. But I know that we was in high school as well. We met 43 years ago. Well, we don't look 43 now. But anyway, we were 43 years ago. And her sister, my sister-in-law, she messed with me all night. She said, well, you wouldn't have Phyllis, it wouldn't for me. So we just eulogized her older sister on this past Tuesday. And during the homegoing service, I told the sister, Rosie, I said, well, thank you, Rosie, for inviting me in the family by allowing me to marry Phyllis. So I thank God for Phyllis. Come on, stand, First Lady Phyllis. Even when we here, I said on Friday she was Evangelist Phyllis, but the Lord have elevated her First Lady. Thank God she was talking to First Lady Benton, and we was on Friday night, and she was giving us some of that First Lady talk. I'm listening. I was okay. I thank God. Okay, share that with her. She was giving us some advice because we knew at this, but we thank God for that. Amen. Our friends here. Amen. We thank God for you. Amen. Tim, it's good to be back home. It's good to be back home. So I done took my 30-second commercial, so now I'm ready to preach. Come on, somebody, I'm ready to preach. And you know it don't take much. I'm about halfway finished right now. I know I'm going to shout again, and you know I'm going to shout. And one thing I'm going to say, what the bishop said, if you think I'm concerned about how the tables are set up, it's just right for me, because he told David, he said, I will prepare a table. Man, you done set the stage. And you may even have some haters at your table. But one thing about it, we don't have no hater aid at the table. But we had a family affair. He said, I will prepare a table in the presence of my enemies. So if your enemy at your table, stop the next thing to come, because it's time to be at your table. I told my folks, I said, when you got an enemy, next time you prepare your natural table, set a plate at the table for them.
Say that.
And I said, when you look at that empty plate, just remind yourself you got an enemy, but you already invited them at the table. They just had came and took the plate. So God, I thank you. If you have your Bibles, amen. If you have your Bibles, if you have your iPads, your iPhones, your iPad, your iWatches, whatever got the scripture, you grab it. Because I want you to hear this word from the Lord. Amen. We're going to the book of Exodus, the 14th chapter, the 13th to the 16th verse. God, I feel you already. That's Exodus, the 14th chapter, verses number 13 to verse number 16. And if you have it, say amen. If you're not, say, Pastor, I'm going there. And I'm going to say, hold what you got. Amen. And if you have it, amen, the word of God reads on this record. I'm reading out of the King James, or God is what version you're coming out of, all is the word of God. Amen. Amen. I've learned that down through the years. Translations does not notify the word. Somebody just put another twist on something that make it out clear to you. If you really don't know Hebrew or Greek, you really don't understand anything. And I thank God for some translation make it a little clearer exactly what the word is saying. But I'm reading this out of the King James, amen, in Exodus 13 through 16, it says, and Moses said unto the people, fear ye not,
and stand still and see the salvation of the Lord, which he will show you today. For the Egyptian whom you have seen today, you shall see them again no more forever. Verse 14 says, the Lord shall fight for you. Oh God, I thank you. And ye shall hold your peace. Verse number 15, which will be a text verse, it says, and the Lord said unto Moses, wherefore crieth thou unto me? Speak unto the children of Israel that they go forward. Verse 16 says, he said, but lift up thy rod and stretch out thy hand over the sea and divide it, and the children of Israel shall go on dry ground through the midst of the sea. Father God, in the name of Jesus, God, I thank you right now for the Logos, which is your written word. God, now as you give me a revelation knowledge, oh God, to speak this word, that your people will hear what you've given me in private, that God, it will be revealed openly unto this congregation. God, we thank you in advance in Jesus' name. Read number verse number 15 and give you a thought. Verse number 15 says, and the Lord said unto Moses, why crieth thou unto me? Speak unto the children of Israel that they may go forward. Look at your neighbor and tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, it's time to go forward. And I'm bringing you with me because it's a family affair. Come on, somebody else, come on. If you catch that, you catch it. I said one more time. Come on, just look at somebody else and say, it's time to go forward. And said, I'm bringing you with me because it's a family affair. Come on, tell the Lord, thank you. Amen. You have heard this story before on how God delivered the children of Israel from the Red Sea. Well, I come to tell you today, it's time to go forward. See, anniversary is a time to reflect back on where you have come from. But now is the time to be looking forward to where God is taking the Cathedral of Praise Church Ministry. Amen. I know a lot of things have happened in 19 years. Amen. And he has to, first of all, one thing I know over the 19 years, amen, he have changed your name. Oh God, somebody. And once God changed a name, he is about to have them to do greater works. Amen. You know the story, man. He had to change Abram, amen, name from Abel to Abraham. Because he was about ready to make him the father of many nations. Oh God, amen. And that brings me, amen, to Moses and the children at the Red Sea. See, sometimes, amen, we don't see what God is telling the leader. But we read here in Exodus 14 and 14, it says, the Lord shall fight for you, and ye shall hold your peace. See, some people, amen, have a problem with holding their peace. Oh, I'm at home so I can talk like this. Amen. Sometimes when the bishop says something, somebody else is murmuring and complaining, amen, because they don't hear what God has told the bishop. Amen. Somebody said, well, bishop, you know, you said that you saw in a dream T.O.P. How in the world can you get T from to T.O.P. to C.O.P., but you don't hear what God told the bishop? Amen. So you can't murmur and complain if you don't hear what God tell the leader, amen. So, man, he had to tell Moses. He said, Moses, he said, just tell them to hold their peace. He said, if they hold their peace, I fight the battle. Sometimes we got to learn to hold our peace and let the Lord fight our battle. Because, amen, you're not the bishop. Amen, the truth be told, I'm glad some of you not bishop. Hold on, I'm going to leave that alone, amen. But I'm home, I can talk like this. Amen, so if you don't mind, amen, tell your neighbors it's time to go forward. And stop looking back. And bring somebody with you. Because it's a family affair. Amen. That bring me. I'm about 5 minutes into it now, Phil. But amen, we see right now over here in Philippians 3 and 13. It reminds me, amen, we shouldn't be looking back, but we need to be moving forward. Because he said, brother, I count not myself to have apprehended. But he said, it's one thing. He said, I forget those things which are behind me. And I'm reaching forth, amen, unto the things which are before. I don't know what God have called you to do, but I dare you to be like the slogan that Nike had. And it said, just do it.
Cause somebody need to just do it, amen. You may not know why you're doing it, but be just like the slogan, it said just do it, So God may be telling you to do something, don't ask God why, but you say, God, I'm gonna be just like Nike, I'm just gonna do it, If you know anything about Nike, Michael's still making shoes, because the slogan, say just do it, So I come to tell you, Cathedra, just keep on doing what you're doing, You may not understand it, but just be like Nike, and tell your neighbor, say, I'm gonna just do it. Glory to God. We thank God for you. Well, let me go back to the text here. And we see here Moses was faced with a situation. Amen. He had to move forward. Because we see here in verse 15 it says, he said, the Lord said unto Moses, he said, wherefore cry thou unto me? He said, speak to the children of Israel that they go forward. See, God has some great things ahead, but you need to be moving forward to get them. See, amen, when we start moving forward, look for obstacles to be in your way. Amen, but I come to tell you, the obstacles are no more than stepping stones to take you higher. See, amen, if you watch me illustrate this, I got those stepping stones that are for me. Truth be told, there are obstacles. I really can't go through this monitor because they are an obstacle. But God allow you to move to the left. God allow you to move to the right. And every one of the stepping stones, I believe down 19 years, Bishop had some obstacles, but he moved to his left. He moved to his right. And being an old drill sergeant, he probably said, left step mark, left heel step.
You can't have fear, but you gotta have faith.
if you're going to move forward. So God told him, he told them, fear not. He said, stand still, oh God, and see the salvation of the Lord. You got to stay with the ministry, and you can't move without direction. See, when the children of Israel left Egypt, they left together, and they followed their leader. We don't see, amen, the vision. Amen, we start complaining, and tell your neighbor, stop complaining. And I'm bringing you with you, because it's a family affair. See, sometimes we complain, and next time somebody at the cathedral, they're complaining, just say, come on, I'm bringing you with me. Say, come on, stop complaining, and let me bring you with you, because it's a family affair. We can't do it all by ourselves. We need our brothers and our sisters, amen, to get where God taking us to. It's a family affair. So that's point number one. And point number two. First point I said, amen, you got to realize you got to have faith, not fear. Point number two, amen, be ready to face your Red Sea. Oh, God, I thank you. See, one thing about when God closed the Red Sea, he just didn't want to drown Pharaoh and his army. But he closed the Red Sea. So the children of Israel were not able to go back. See, I come to tell you, God got to close some of your Red Sea. I know there was many days when Pastor Benton and First Lady Benton wanted a man to go back. But he realized that the Red Sea was closed. So what the need for him to try to go back? Because the Red Sea was closed. See, sometimes God brings it to the Red Sea that you try to go back. But God didn't only drown Pharaoh, but he closed the Red Sea. Because if he didn't close the Red Sea, they would have went back to Egypt. So if God had not closed the Red Sea, we probably would have went back. But you said, I'm in the midst of the Red Sea. So God, you got to bring me through my Red Sea. So I come to tell you today, there's going to be some Red Sea, Pastor. But keep on walking through your Red Sea. You might get right in the middle. You can't go back. You can't go to the left, but you gotta stay in the middle of your Red Sea. And while you're in the middle, God will begin to deliver you in the midst of the sea. To the Lord, thank you. Stay in the middle of your Red Sea, because it's a family affair. And my third and final point, I'm gonna hoop here in a minute. My third and final point. Stop looking back and redeem the time. Look at somebody. Tell them, stop looking back and redeem the time. Amen. Because the Bible says over in Ephesians, he says, stop looking back and redeem the time. Because the days are evil. Amen. We know the days of evil. There's no time to looking back. We got to keep moving forward. And we ain't got no time of wasting time. Brother Phil, we got to redeem the time. Because God is soon to come, and you ain't got time, amen, going back. Well, that bring me over to Miss Lot. Amen. God told Lot. He told Moses they go able to go get Lot and his family. But Miss Lot saw what she liked in Sodom. The Bible said in Genesis 26, amen, he said she looked back. The first thing God told him said, get Lot and your family. Tell somebody it's a family affair. So he could have just asked for Lot, but he said, get Miss Lot and bring her on. So what I'm trying to tell you, if your family ain't saved, bring them anyhow, because they're part of the family. You know the story. So Miss Lot, she came, but she looked back, and God made a pillar of salt. So David Cathedral, we can't look back. We gotta keep moving forward. Cause we don't wanna turn into a pool of salt. We don't wanna miss what God got for us. But keep looking back. But we gotta keep looking forward. The Bible says, he that put his hand to the plow and looked back is not fit for the kingdom of heaven. I refuse to look back. I got my mind made up. Got my mind made up. I'm not looking back. I'm going forward. And I'm bringing you with me. And the story goes on and said, as he looked back, he told him that he was going to destroy Sodom and Gomorrah for their wickedness. Amen. We have come too far. to go back. Amen. When we think that all the Lord has done for us. Amen. I can also testify. I've been here, amen, amen, 5 of the 19 years. And amen, there was a lot of opposition, amen, faced the ministry. And I know Bishop don't mind me saying, some folks said they're going to close the doors. But amen, I remember, amen, we went into prayer. We went into shut-ins. We begin to hold up the man and woman of God hands. And amen, because that reminds me we was a family. We was going to let the devil steal what God said was ours. And if you look at 19 years, what they thought wasn't yours, now you own it. Because amen, the people realize what God got for you, can't nobody take from you. So I come to tell you on this afternoon, amen, it's time to move forward and bring somebody with you, because we are a family affair, amen. They said, amen, we wasn't going to make it, but I'm here to tell you today, God done add to the church. God is bringing new members in, amen. And I hate to tell you, some of them have to go, and some of you should have said bye-bye. I see you later. I see you and I don't want to be you. Because you were making up rumor that God had somebody that I could use in the ministry. So I come to tell you on this afternoon, look at your neighbor one last time and tell your neighbor it's time to move forward. And I'm bringing you with me. Bring somebody and bring them with you. You know where I'm going. You coming where I'm going, because I'm bringing you with me. We can't go back, because the Red Sea have already been closed. But we can't do nothing but go forward. We can't do nothing but go forward. But these are, you got to go forward. You got to go forward. You got to go forward. You can't go back. You can't turn around. God has brought you too far to go back now. It's time to go forward. It's time to go forward. I'm bringing you with me. Grab somebody. Grab somebody. Come here, Bishop. Come here, First Lady. I need you right here. Come here. I feel God. I feel like preaching. Stand right. Look at that way. If you're part of the cathedral, let's link up. Let's hook up. Come on. Come on, get behind me. Because they be going forward. So wherever they go, we going with you. We going forward. We going forward. We going forward. We're calling a man of God. We're calling a woman of God. We're going forward. We're going forward. As he leading us, we can't get in front of him. We gotta stand behind him. We can't get in front of him. We gotta stand behind him. But every now and then, we got a few that wanna get ahead. But they gotta follow the leader. They gotta follow the leader. Thank you, Bishop. Thank you, First Lady. You can't get in front of him, but you gotta follow them. Tell somebody thank you. We can't get in front of them. We gotta follow them. They're coming as family. They're coming as family. They're bringing somebody with them. Bring somebody with you. Bring somebody with you. Bring somebody with you. Come on, they're coming. Look at them, Bishop. They're coming as family. They're coming as family. They got their hands going together. They're coming as family. It's a family affair. I'm about to have a preaching fit. I feel God in here. They're coming right now. They're coming as family. And God is doing it. Look around us. There's no time to look in back. And it's time for us to go forward. Everything to my left. left can't get in front of me. Everything on my peripherals can't get in front of me. So I gotta follow my leaders as he followed Christ. Because Moses didn't want to go. You know the story? Moses said, I can't speak. And God said, that's all right. I give you a mouthpiece. I make Joshua. I make Aaron. Speak for you. These are like a ventriloquist. Who says, open your mouth. And Aaron will do the speaking. Come here, Joshua. He said, now Moses is dead. But the children are still going forward. So I come to tell you, God got the man. God got the woman. But you can't go back. You gotta go forward. And you gotta bring somebody with you. Hey, yeah. Lord, thank you. I'm out of time. But I'm not out of words. It's time. Look at somebody and say, it's time to go forward. And I'm bringing you with me because it's a family affair. In my closing, it's time to move forward. I'm bringing you with me because it's a family affair. I know you're prepping for 20 years, but appreciate the 19th years. Thank you, Holy Ghost. There's no need to do things premature, but it's also important not to procrastinate. Hear what I'm saying? You should be looking forward to 20. Brother Davis had us say last night, no more 19. So everything happened at the conclusion of this anniversary, starting today. It's time to go forward. Everything that happened, but it's time to go forward. It's all right to reflect on what then happened. But you need to prepare yourself where God is taking you to. Bishop shared some things with me. I'm not going to share with you. I let him share with his own church. But the vision that he has in your 20 years is going to blow your mind. What I'm here to tell you, encouraging, I'm family as well. You know the story. The children of Israel start to complain. Begin to murmur among one another. It got to the point where Moses was ready to give up. You read the rest of the text. Moses was ready to give up. The Lord had to remind him. He told Moses one thing. He said, Moses, what you have in your hand? Moses is a rod. God told him, stretch forth the rod. As he stretched forth the rod, the story say, man, the waters begin to divide. He said, water was on the left, water was on the right. The children don't go back because Pharaoh was behind them. They didn't understand how they were going to go, but as I read in verse number 16, he said, the Lord allowed them to go cross on dry ground. So you just need to keep moving forward, Cathedral. Your dry ground is prepared for you to walk on. Your dry ground is ready for you to walk on. And every enemy, oh God, I feel you. God, I hear you now. And as you get into the middle of the Red Sea and on the dry ground, you will have those that are going to be chasing you. But as they begin to chase you, you're going to realize, why can't I catch you? Because the place that they're walking is not dry, it's still muddy. Pharaoh got right in the middle. The Bible says he was making a high pursuit. Out of midst of nowhere, God closed the Red Sea. My brother, my friend, stay in the middle of the Red Sea. Everything that's trying to catch you, they can't catch you because you're ahead of them. And everything that tried to destroy you, God gonna destroy them. But here, I'm gonna tell you, the cathedral, you gotta bring somebody along. Because it's a family affair. The partnership here, bring them along. I'm in D.C., bring me along. Bring us in that we can get through to the other side. You know the story, the children got to the other side. Maybe you here this afternoon, you stuck at your Red Sea. You can't really go back. Because what you left from is not where you need to go back to. You need to stay right where you at. God's sending you here to the cathedral. This is where you need to be. I tell my folks all the time, church is not going to look like us. If you're looking for church to look like you, you might as well close your doors. I told mine, that if they come in from stinking, from drinking, you give them the best seat in the house. If you can't stand the alcohol, I need to pray for you because you ain't delivered.
Oh my God.
My church in the middle of Washington, D.C., right in the heart of Florida, Northeast Washington, D.C., and everywhere you look, last Sunday there was a drive-by right in front of the church. Don't know where, but bring them in. I don't care if they come in, man, if the blunt fell on the floor, fine. One of the demons pick it up, don't you smoke it, give it back to them.
Oh, my God.
I'm telling my wife will tell you, I tell them every Sunday, bring them in here. Sharing with Bishop, a musician, great musician. Phil is awesome. This brother, some of you may back in the day may remember in D.C. used to play with a go-go band called Trouble Funk. How many remember? Some of you might got the tape in your car. But anyway, he's a bad musician. Came to me and said, "But Pastor, I'm still smoking weed." I said, "Brother Maurice, keep playing for the Lord, and Lord will deliver you from smoking weed." Now, I said, "Oh, Pastor, that was right." No, because if he stayed long enough, God gonna deliver him. I could have sent him away and they went back and smoked more weed. He reckoned that he was honest enough to tell me that what he's doing, I was God enough to say, "Okay, you keep doing what you're doing until God delivered you." So what I'm trying to tell you, let him come. Long you moving forward, Bishop, they going with you. Maybe somebody here today. Come on, the altar's open. Come on. You